Hey folks, old Bart Wilson and Sweetie Pie here today. It's Sunday, July the 10th. Ain't that right?
That's correct. You got it.
July the 10th.
You got it there, Biggie.
We're going to give y'all a little, a quick little video today. We're not going to spend a lot of time. Flossie has tweaked her back, and she's sitting in a straight back chair, and I don't want her to hurt herself because I really need her healthy. Cause we got a lot of work coming up around the old pond, the road, the hacienda day bar fun. So anyway, I need to get her heel back up. So to help her save her back, we're gonna try to keep this quick today. It's hot, people. It's hot. I've been sweating like a prize pig at a July state fair. It's terrible. Oh, I'm ready. So ready for fall and winter. But anyway, I'm going to tell you some stories about what's been going on as we carve, just kind of move this thing along a little bit to help Flossie out. So we're going to get back on our piece. Now last week, or the last time we did a video, we worked on that face and brought the nose and the eyes and all that out. Now I decided I'm going to put a mustache on mine, and I'm going to show you how we're going to do that. And then we're going to move down and start blocking in some of these clothes. All right, and then we're probably about going to call it a day on that so Flossie can go rest her back.
I was trying to maneuver.
Oh, see folks, see she's not on the
right thing. I didn't maneuver right.
Yeah, so anyway, I've already drawn my mustache out right here. So let me start carving it and then I'll show it to you. So let me get my, I got to get my eyeballs on.
So what do you think about your new grill?
The new grill's awesome. I'm going to get to that in a minute. We got a couple of three things to talk about.
Yeah, you've cooked some really
first thing is the other day I promised Chucky Ducky, because y'all was kind of picking on me about still being on restriction. Well, I promised Chucky Ducky I would let out what Flossie bought me last Saturday. Flossie went and bought me a steel chainsaw for cutting firewood this year. Yeah, folks, old Bart Wilson's got him a chainsaw now.
Yeah.
Flossie scared slap to death right now. But anyway, she'll be all right.
Come in with a arm cut off.
Yeah, well, it ain't be an arm cut off today. But anyway, that's one thing. I said that for Chucky Ducky because he was asking. So, one thing I'm going to show you, the knife I'm going to use today, this is one of my signature four Shrimp King Helvey knives. This is an old one. This was the very first one. That's number one right there. And you can tell when I pull this off, it has been tweaked down a lot. So, but anyway, this is what we're going to use today. So, let me start carving here. So, let's see. I need to, we'll make me a little niche cut right there. And one right there around the nose, like that right there. And I'm going to take a little wedge out right there like that. See that? Can you see that? That's sweet pie.
Turn it just a little bit the other way. Yep. Okay, there we go. Good.
Nice. See that little notch? Okay, now I'm just gonna take my knife and come down just a little bit, like that right there, down to the bottom. And I'm gonna lay my knife flat, and I'm gonna take that cheek out to bring that mustache out a little bit. Turn it back around this way and clean that out a little bit. You want to kind of taper that jaw, and we'll knock that. All right, see how I done that?
Mm-hmm.
Right now, we're going to come over here and do the same thing on the other side. So, all right, now I'm going to talk a little bit, and the same thing on this side, all right? Mm-hmm. So, along with last weekend, if any of y'all have been on Facebook yet this morning, y'all seen my other new toy. and Sweetie Pie bought me a grill that goes in the ground that I can put over our fire pit. See how I did that?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so that's about all I'm gonna do. So now we wanna go take this out in front. And I'm gonna take these pencil marks off that I had on here and kind of shape this up a little bit more, kind of make it kind of round into the face a little bit more. And then I'll redraw it and show it to y'all. But anyway, it's a grill that goes in the ground, it sticks in the ground, and it'll swing around over the top of our fire pit, and I can cook over it. So last night, I cooked some bacon-wrapped chicken wings on it, carried it to the neighbor's pool party.
And they were really good.
And they were good. Well, today, I cooked some cilantro kind of marinade. They're going to end up being chicken bacon quesadillas. So. Okay. Can you see that, what I drew on there?
Yep. I sure can.
All right. Now we're going to cut that in. All right, now. Right here in these corners, we want to go fairly deep. All right. So I generally hold, when I do stuff like this, I hold my knife like a pencil and I poke it straight down as far as I can. Well, not as far as I can, but pretty good ways. And I come back and catch that corner again and go down right here. All right. See, I got it in there pretty good, folks. See there? See, I can,
mm-hmm.
It's in there a good quarter inch, if you can see that.
Yeah.
Tip of that blade. So then what I do is I catch that and I pull that wedge out. And hope all the boogers comes out with it. Sometimes you might have to go in there and kind of straighten it up a little. All right. So then we're going to go over here on the other side and we're going to do the same thing. Alright, so I've told y'all about the grill and my new toy. Alright, sorry about that, I got a little concentrated here. I need to straighten this nose out right here. Hold on one.
Who was it that had made a comment on your patch?
Larry Youngblood. You was right.
You were right. We didn't even notice.
See, I ain't from Oklahoma, Larry. Hell, I don't know which way y'all fly your flag out there.
I didn't even notice it. Even when you said something, I was like, no, it's got to be the camera.
I had to go pull up the state capitol building and
shame on me.
Yeah,
being from Oklahoma, I didn't even notice.
All right, so see how we got that? See them deep corners right there?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so right in the middle, there's still a little piece left. All right, mm-hmm. So I don't take a whole lot out in the middle. I just take enough out for shadow. See that, Sweetie Pie?
Mm-hmm. Yep,
I see it. Fix this side of the nose now. There we go, that looks better. All right, now. And then I just take these lines down. Cause we got to come in there and we got to get the bottom lip out. So don't get too carried away. You just want to take some little wedges out. Like that right there. Now, on this mustache, I go in and just kind of lightly take them sharp edges off that we left when we cut them stop cuts in there. All right. There. Mm-hmm. Everybody see that? That looks really good. Now we got to go right here, and we're going to bring out a little bit of a lip. All right, but I got to do a little straightening right here. First of all, I'm going to take that and kind of knock that down back toward the neck a little bit. That's going to help that lip protrude out. I got one little spot right here I need to get a little bit out of right there. All right, there we go. All right, everybody see that? Mm-hmm. See it from the side?
I believe so.
All right, now we need to get that bottom lip out. What I'm gonna use for that, I'm gonna take my 5mm number 9 Swiss, the baby brother to my favorite tool. Now, you can make this as thick as you want. And I got to fix one little thing right here, people. Hold on one second. I got to taper that right there. There we go. Now we looking gooder. All right, so this area is going to be the lip. I want to flatten it out just a little bit. All right, there we go. All right, now I'm going to go in there. Can you see that all right?
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'm going to go in there and I'm going to take that and make a bottom lip. So let me cut it and I'll show you. And I basically just kind of come straight up under that lip. And then I kind of try to turn it just a little bit. And I got one little chip right there. All right. Now, let me cut that one more time. Now, if you want this lip to poke out a little bit more, you can come back when you make that cut. I come back with my 3mm number 11 and just run right up in the same path that 5mm done. Now, when you get in here doing this, be real careful. So then, chip outs. All right, so right here at the bottom of the lip on each corner, I'm going to take out just a tiny little wedge. See that wedge? Can you see it, Flossie?
Mm-hmm.
All right. I do that on each side, and that kind of shows a little shadow going up behind that mustache. All right? Just like that.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we got to make one ticklish little cut here. I want to go right in the middle of that lip, and I want to make a little tiny dished out cut, just like that. And then reach back there and knock it out like that. That kind of gives that lip a little bit of a, it ain't so flat in there. Mm-hmm. It gives it a little curve. All right. So now, this chin, we can come in here, this chin, and we can take that harsh line out a little bit. And kind of knock some of these harsh lines out. Kind of round it the best way we can. If you have to, right here, I got to go back a little bit. There we go. And my lip, I had a piece chip out on mine. I don't know if it's because I pushed the gouge in there too deep and it hit the wing, or if that wood just, it'd be all right. There we go. I'm going to leave it alone, because if I keep picking at it, it's just going to get worse and worse.
It looks good.
So we'll leave it. Did everybody see how we did the mouth and the mustache? Okay, now, I'm going to drop down here to these arms, and we're going to start taking these sleeves out on these arms. All right, so generally what I do is I just kind of eyeball it, and I mark one. All right? So when I mark one, I look at it. I'm like, yeah, that's good enough for a hand. So then I get me a measurement. Remember I calibrated measurement tool, y'all? I kind of get me a measurement, and I come back here on this side. And I kind of, that way it kind of, they kind of keep even, all right? And then I'll mark. Let me see something. We need to knock that out a little bit. All right, before I cut that in, right there on this 1 foot, I need to take a little bit of that leg out. So I'm going to take my favorite tool, and I'm going to come right in there like that. That kind of thin that leg up a little bit. I'm going to do a little bit right here too. This one kind of, okay. The life to make a world living. All right. Clean that up right there. All right, now, on these arms, you can do several things here. This is the shirt sleeve. This is hand. This is shirt sleeve right here. Now, you can run a V-tool on this. You can use a 3mm number 11, or you can use your knife. I'm just going to use my knife. So I just make me a stop cut right there, and I just take me a little bit out. But you got to remember, when you do that on the back of this hand, you want to keep this flat, because that's the back plane of the hand right here, this part right here. And we'll get to that in another day. And I just kind of take and work that around. I don't go real deep with it. I don't take a lot out. I just make it about an eighth inch difference right there. About that right there. And I just bring it on around. You don't have to get real aggressive with this, okay? Go ahead and start my three planes of the hand. Bring that hand out a little bit more down here on the end. Like that right there. All right, now, before I move to this side, I want this hand, all right, I'm kind of holding my hand kind of like this. And if you see, my hand kind of slopes, it kind of curves around right there at the bottom. Y'all kind of see that?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so if you see, I got my hand blocky. All right, so what I want to do is I want to take this part of the bottom off. So I just kind of come in there and take me like about a 45, and then I come back and kind of refine those planes a little bit. And if it looks like you're starting to get your shirt sleeve a little thicker right there, then you won't. It's okay, because we're gonna shave this arm down a little bit too when we detail this arm, all right? So we're kind of sort of laying some detail in, but we're kind of sort of still laying out the foundations. Before we laid out the foundations for the body, now we're laying the foundations for the detail on the body. Okay, does that make sense to everybody?
I believe it does.
All right, so now, see how we got that hand laid in there now?
Mm-hmm.
Now we'll come back and do some we'll do some detail on that hand and that arm and get that straightened out, all right? So then we want to go to this side. Now this side, I'm going to have him holding something. So we're going to, basically, we're going to do the same thing. Actually, you know what? I'm going to move this line forward a little bit. And then, let's see. Let me get that. Come here, little dude. Rise away. Alright, so I'm going to do that. Remember, we will keep that flat, that back of that hand flat. And we just want to bring it out. Okay, now. I see this a lot in beginner carvers. When they carving a hand that's out here like this, can you see me okay right here? When they carving a hand, the bottom of this hand, the top is forward and the bottom's back. I see a lot of them, it looks like that. And the bottom's out and the top's back. So the way we remedy that is we take and we're going to slant this hand back a little bit. Can you see that line on it, Mr. Clausen? And then all you got to do is kind of start top and let it get deep like that. See how we just slanted that hand back? All right, now. Then I want to remember on the other side where we took this bottom out and kind of turned that hand in. We're going to do the same thing on this side. And then we're gonna get our planes in there a little bit, like that. Take that off. All right. Now, all right. So that's how we're gonna do that right there. Our hand is set. Our hands are set up now for detailing. Now this hand over here, his thumb's gonna be down here kind of like this. And then we'll bore a hole right there, kind of holding something like that. This thumb is gonna be kind of like this, and the hand's just gonna be kind of laying flat like that, okay? Kind of like that. So, but anyway, here, I'll show that real good right there. I know it doesn't look like we did a lot, folks, but we actually did. We're starting to get some detail. I'll show you this right here real quick. We'll go ahead and, well, I'll tell you what, we'll wait. We'll wait, because we'll start, next week I'll start bringing out the breeches and the heels of the shoes down here, all right? That's where we'll start next week, and we'll go back and work on this body some more, okay? But I got to let Flossie go rest her back. So she can,
it's ridiculous.
You know, yeah,
My back is ridiculous.
Well, I mean, folks, I had her loading hay the other day. I mean, she only threw 50 bales of hay, and now she's complaining about her back hurt. You know, any woman like from this. Oklahoma ought to be able to throw 50 bales of hay. Am I right or wrong, y'all?
I can throw 50 bales of hay.
Okay. Well, then why are you complaining about a sore back?
Garden and all this stuff.
Oh,
and
my
then
Lord.
One
here we go.
Turn.
Here we go. Here we go.
Wrong you, turn.
Now
this
y'all
is my
see
back.
What I'm up against.
It's just
there
craziness.
Y'all see. I really didn't have her throwing hay, y'all. I just picked
but
it up.
But it was one small little turn.
Yep. She just tweaked her back a little bit. Now she's laid up. So, but anyway, like I said, I know, here, I'll hold this up there again real quick while I'm talking. I know this looks like it wasn't much, but we're getting there, folks. You know, I may be kind of dragging this out because I don't want to leave y'all yet. You know what I mean? I might not be ready to turn y'all loose yet on the world. You know, y'all kind of like my little children, you know?
Your little carving kids.
My little carving kids, you know. I love y'all. Yeah, I just like Wahoo. I didn't tell y'all Wahoo story because there really ain't one this week, y'all. He's gathering up his stuff to go out west. Him and brother Rich are going, you know, traveling together, you know, sometime end of the summer. And he's all excited. Oh, he got him a new sippy cup. Got him a brand new box of crayons to eat on the ride out there. Brother Dart's gonna have his hands full. Got him some brand new SpongeBob underoos. Oh, he's ready to go.
Underoos.
Yeah, he's all excited, y'all. He's all excited.
I wonder if they even have those.
Yeah, they do. They got them in adult sizes. Cause Wahoo got some the other day. Okay. But anyway, look here. Like I said, I know it doesn't look like we did a lot, but we actually did. Mm-hmm. The face is done except for the hair, and we got to do a little bit more on his do-rag up there, and we'll get that hair textured. But basically, his face is done. We just got a little bit, you know, to bring out some more clothes and do some refining down here on the body, and we'll be about done, y'all. And then we're going to do this one, and me and Flossie's going to take a break, and we may get up with y'all maybe about the end of October, November, something. Maybe
I think we ought to do a Halloween.
Yeah, I'm thinking we might do a Halloween something this year. I'd find something. Maybe we'll do maybe come up doing a vampire or something out of a block of wood or something like that. I don't know. I'll think about it. We'll think about it and see what we can. Y'all, we've done a pumpkin. So we'll do something. We'll figure something out. But anyway, we're going to jump off of here because on my new grill today, I cooked up some lime, cilantro, marinated chicken.
Chicken bacon, yeah, quesadillas.
Chicken, right? Bacon ranch quesadillas is what we have for supper today, folks. But anyway, y'all have a good week. Y'all try to stay cool. You know, I'm hearing my buddies, everybody saying it's hot everywhere. It is hot. Yeah. Lord mercy, it's hot.
It is hot.
I'm about ready for a breath of fall. So, but anyway, y'all have a good week. Y'all take care of yourself. Take care of your neighbors and all and all that. Y'all get the carving, do your carving and all, and we'll get back to it. Again, me and Flossie want to tell y'all again, you know, we have a lot of followers, and y'all are great people. We love every one of y'all.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of nice comments from me and Flossie. You know, y'all, we do appreciate each and every one of them. You know, we really do. And
yes, we do.
Y'all, you know, y'all, each and every one of y'all means something to us. So y'all don't ever think you don't, because you do.
You do.
You know,
sure.
We hate when we can't do these for y'all on a regular basis. But you know how it is. Life just comes in the way of sometimes. And so anyway. But anyhow, I'm going to get off of here because we got some chicken quesadillas to eat this afternoon. And I'm going to relax a little bit. Flossie worked me to death again this weekend, y'all. So, but anyway, y'all take care. Y'all take care. We'll see you next week. Me and Flossie are out. Bye-bye now.
Bye.